there are many examples that demonstrate that we can increase the interest in STEM subjects if we change the way in which we work, starting from the first grades of schooling. Today, I would like to give you some suggestions selected from some of my lessons on how to make children grow many competencies, starting from problem solving, math skills, and digital literacy, using unplugged coding activities first, and some simple games and projects involving also some robotic kids later. Robots capture the interest of students because they are related with games. Robots promote team working and collaboration among students, which are powerful means of deepening the learning methodology. In kindergarten and early elementary classrooms, manipulative materials and games play an important role in children's learning, enabling children to explore mathematical and scientific concepts such as number, shape, and size through direct manipulation of physical objects. I would introduce young students to a programming language by making them practice with a little game, to be sure they understand what is a procedure. After such introduction, we can start to use robots. So, blind one volunteer with a scarf, he will be a submarine. Ask another participant, the pilot, to put his hands on submarine's shoulders and drive it from one point to another, following the instruction of classmates. As we wanted to work only with lower level instructions, the only possible comment would be one step ahead, turn that side, meaning this turn 19 on the right, turn this side, meaning by this turn 90 on the left. After the first ice-breaking game, it is now time to put on the floor some colored circles for the orientation games. Participants are split in groups. One of them is the executor, who moves over the game surface. The others are the programmers, who have to compile the procedure to make the executor move from the start and reach a certain target, while solving some problems and completing the levels, like in a digital game. Little children love games. To help them become makers and build their own games, it is possible, after practicing the coding hands-on activity on the ground, to introduce them to use a simple programming language, like Scratch Junior, and ask them to help the seahorse to reach the sea fish. Then, to fix the concept, some lesson will use the BeBot. That is perfect because it uses a script forward, left, right, making it moving through colors. Teachers can use a robot to teach many subjects. They can develop, for instance, concepts such as sensing, that is the perception of environment, by exploring the use of sensor of robots. Of course, when working with the little children, the approach is different. If we want to study some facts about crocodiles, things are more engaging. Using distance sensor to make the crocodile's mouth closing when an object is coming near. In the video, you can see anyway that the teacher has to make some little adjustments, stopping the program to increase the sense of mystery in the narration. As children grow older and learn more advanced concepts, the educational focus shifts away from direct manipulation to more abstract formal methods. It becomes very useful to employ some learning mediators that Resnick calls computationally enhanced manipulative materials, which aim to enable children to continue learning with a kindergarten approach and helps them to learn concepts and grow competencies that were previously considered too advanced for them. For example, the use of robotic kits like Lego WeDo, together with Scratch programming, improves the learning process. In fact, the children can understand the link between the hardware movement and the specific program that they wrote. A simple activity that helps in this purpose shows simple effects of rotations and the rotation direction. Working with older students, like those in the fourth or fifth grades, it's possible to introduce cause-effect action, like those we gain when blowing into the microphone or using the distance sensor. The power of motors and the turns of the mill, in fact, depends on the intensity of the blue, or the distance measured. Best results come when observing the velocity of wheels while blowing the sound sensor of a Lego Mindstorm, while using the test sensor program on the brick. I hope these examples had provided you with an idea of why and how you can start to use robots in your classroom.